There are many videos out there that tell you how to input audio into Clubhouse. However, I haven't found any video that tells you how to connect all the platforms together. You want yourself and the audiences on the two platforms to hear each other. If that's what you're looking for, this video is for you. I'll provide you with a step-by-step guide to make it work. I will show you how to do it without a physical mixer. Watch the video until the end, because I will be sharing with you two cheat sheet screenshots for the OBS and Streamyard or Restream configurations. So let's go. I'm interviewing my friend Marco from Thailand. Hello, Marco.
Hello, everybody. Hi, Marco.
And I'm broadcasting it to OBS that sends the video and audio to YouTube. So we are live on my YouTube channel now. I also have my wife Marlene on Clubhouse. If I'm sharing the screen of my iPhone, the audio for some reason doesn't work, so I will have to disconnect. We are streaming live to YouTube and Clubhouse at the same time, and we have the two platforms connected. So the audience on Zoom, which is then broadcasted to YouTube, can hear Clubhouse. Marco, are you hearing Marlene?
Yes. Hi, Marco.
And the audience on Clubhouse can hear the one on Zoom. Marlene, can you hear me?
Yes.
You, Marlene, you're hearing Mark as well.
Yes.
And myself, as the host, I can hear everybody. It works. So let's assume, as it is my case, you want to do an interview on Zoom and broadcast that to YouTube and Clubhouse. I'm using Zoom and OBS, but if you're using Streamyard or Restream to stream to YouTube, I'll provide a solution also for you. In order to do that, you need a few pieces of equipment and a digital audio mixer. Let's have a look. You'll find the detailed list of all the hardware in the description. The first piece is the iRig2. Then you'll need an Apple Lightning to 3.5mm headphone jack adapter. Two male-male cables, 3.5mm jack, 3.5mm jack. And an audio converter, I have the Linde one, from audio to USB. Two audio adapters, 3.5mm jack plug to 6.3mm jack socket. A USB microphone, I have the Blue Yeti for example, your headphones with a 3.5mm jack, and your phone, an iPhone or iPad if you want to stream to Clubhouse. If you're on a Mac, you may need different type of adapters. So let's take the iRig2 and connect the Apple Lightning to 3.5mm headphone jack adapter. Then let's connect it to your phone. We then take the 3.5mm to the 6.3mm jack adapter and put it in the socket with the guitar sign. We then plug the 3.5mm audio cable into it. It's now time to connect the other end of the 3.5mm audio cable to your computer headphone output. Now all the sound from your PC is going out to the iRig2 and then to your phone. The iRig also takes the sound from the phone and can send it back. Let's now plug the cables to send the audio from the iRig2 back to the computer. We take the 3.5mm to 6.3mm jack adapter and plug it into the amplifier output on the iRig2. Then we connect to it one end of the 3.5mm male-male audio cable. We then take the audio converter and plug it to one USB 3 socket on your PC. The other end of the 3.5mm audio cable should now go into the mic input of your audio converter. By doing so, the audio will go from your iPhone to your PC. So the audio is going out from the PC to the phone through the iRig, and from the phone again through the iRig back to the PC. The last thing we need to do is make sure we also hear all the sound. So we need to take our headphones, but remember, we've already used the headphone output of the PC to connect it to the iRig2. So now we have to use the headphone jack from our audio adapter. Last but not least, if you have a USB external mic, you have to connect it to a USB port on your computer. This was for the hardware you need. In case you don't have a physical mixer, you will need to install a digital one. The most known digital free audio mixer is Voicemeeter from VB Audio. There are three versions, the basic one Voicemeeter, then Voicemeeter Banana and Voicemeeter Potato. They're basically all the same, but they have a different number of inputs and outputs. What I have and what I suggest you to download is Voicemeeter Banana. The software is donationware, it means you can use it for free, but it's recommended to do a little donation, as low as $1, $2, or $5. If you're on a Mac, you may use Loopback, which is an alternative to Voicemeeter that you can set up in a similar way. In a nutshell, how does it work? You have your hardware input, so the sound coming from outside, it could be your Yeti microphone, any other microphone, and in our case we will also have the audio coming from your phone. Then you have the virtual inputs that we'll cover in a second, the hardware outputs, so where you want to send the sound physically to, and then two virtual outputs. So what's a virtual input and a virtual output and a virtual audio cable? A virtual audio cable is basically a piece of software that simulates to the computer a real audio cable. With a virtual input, you can capture the sound coming from any part of the computer, put it through the virtual cable, so through the software, and then outputting it to another virtual output. It will become clearer in a second. Let's now set up your audio on Voicemeeter. So what are the different sources here? You have your microphone, your voice, you have the audio coming from Zoom, so your guest, and you have the audio coming from Clubhouse. Let's start with your voice. I have a Blue Yeti USB microphone that is connected to the PC with a real hardware cable. So the microphone is a hardware input. In this illustration, I will use a continuous black line to identify hardware, so real cables. For convenience, we'll set it on Voicemeeter as hardware input 1. You want your voice to be heard by your audience on Clubhouse. Then you want the persons you're interviewing on Zoom or Skype to hear it too. And last but not least, you want your voice to be sent to OBS, which then will send it to YouTube or Twitch, so that the audience there will hear it too. We need to send the signal coming from the hardware input 1 to 3 different outputs. Clubhouse is on our phone, which is connected to the PC through a real hardware audio cable. We can then choose the first Voicemeeter hardware output, A1. Then we need to send the voice to Zoom or Skype. Zoom is an application, so we'll use a virtual output with a virtual audio cable. The first virtual output provided by Voicemeeter is identified as B1. In this illustration, I'm drawing all the virtual cables with a blue dotted line. The virtual cable takes the signal out from B1 and sends it through its out virtual jack to Zoom. By default, the virtual cable that is associated to the B1 output is called VB Vio. As a last step, we need to send our voice also to OBS. Also, OBS is an application, so we need an additional virtual output. Luckily, Voicemeeter has two built-in virtual outputs, so we'll select B2. The virtual cable that is associated to the B2 output is called VB Aux. This cable will take the signal from the digital mixer and send it out through the virtual Aux out jack to OBS. So for hardware input 1, we need to toggle A1, output going to Clubhouse, B1, output going to Zoom, and B2, output going to OBS. In this case, it's already toggled because I'm recording my voice for this tutorial on OBS. We're now good for your voice. The next step is sending the audio from Clubhouse back to the PC. We've done this plugging a real audio cable to the USB audio adapter. Your PC will see this audio adapter as a microphone. We will choose it as a hardware input 2 on Voicemeeter. On Voicemeeter, we go to Hardware Input 2 and select USB Audio Device. Who needs to hear the voice coming from Clubhouse? Well, not Clubhouse, because we don't want to send the signal back. We don't want people to hear themselves. But indeed, it should go to Zoom or Skype, because we want to put the two platforms into communication. And we have to send it out also to OBS, so that our audience on YouTube or Twitch will hear it. We're almost done, but we're missing one thing, which is yourself. You need to hear the voice coming from Clubhouse too, right? And you do that through your headphones. Your headphones are a hardware output. So let's choose the next free hardware output on Voicemeeter, that is A2. Headphones are connected through a physical cable. We now tell Voicemeeter that our new output A2 should go to the headphones. The way I set it up, I connected my headphones to the socket on the USB audio device. So this is what I will be choosing as hardware output A2. Very good. We have our hardware input 2, and now we have to tell Voicemeeter that it should send it out to the three outputs we have identified. So not A1, because we don't want the audio coming from Clubhouse to go back into Clubhouse, but in the order as we set it up before, to B1, Zoom or Skype, B2, OBS, and then to YouTube or Twitch, and the new hardware output, A2, so to our headphones. Now you don't see any bar moving here because I'm not connected to Clubhouse. Our last audio source is the guest on Zoom or Skype. These are applications, so the sound is a virtual input. Let's choose the first virtual input offered by Voicemeeter, which is the Voicemeeter Vio. The sound will come from Zoom or Skype into our computer through Voicemeeter Vio in. Who needs to hear the voice coming from Zoom? Our audience on Clubhouse, yourself, not Zoom, so we don't want to send the signal back to Zoom, but we do want to send it to OBS and then YouTube and Twitch. By now you figured out which outputs we need to toggle. A1, Clubhouse, A2, your headphones, and B2, OBS. The last thing we need to do is to make sure that Zoom knows where it has to take the sound from and where it has to send it to. This won't be your usual microphone and headphones, but instead will be your Vio out as a microphone and Vio in as a speaker. You select Vio in as a speaker instead of your headphones because you're not the only one who needs to hear the voice from Zoom. Also those on Clubhouse need to hear it, and also those on OBS. You then select the VB Audio Vio output as your microphone. That's because you don't want to send to Zoom your voice only. Instead, you want to send your voice and the one coming from Clubhouse. In a similar way, you shouldn't be defining your microphone as the audio source on OBS. Instead, you should choose as an audio input to OBS the VB AUX out, because through this cable, we're collecting the audio from your microphone, from Clubhouse, and from Zoom. If you wish, you can take a screenshot of this illustration. We have a similar configuration if you're using Streamyard or Restream. Instead of Zoom or Skype, you will have Streamyard or Restream as an audio source. You're not using OBS, so you can forget about it. So the setup is actually simpler, as you need one virtual output less. We have to toggle the right buttons to adapt to this new configuration. Your microphone is going out to A1, Clubhouse, that's still correct, B1, which is now a Streamyard that also goes to YouTube, and B2, we don't need it anymore. Hardware input 2, the sound from Clubhouse, is going to your headphones, A2, still correct, to Streamyard or Restream, B1, and now we don't need B2, so we remove it. Now the sound coming from Streamyard or Restream is going to Clubhouse, A1, your headphones, A2, and again, we remove B2. And here's your screenshot for the Restream or Streamyard configuration. If you found this video useful, consider subscribing and watch my next videos. See you soon with the next digital idea.